Hey friends, this is Sunil Sharma and today I'm going to talk about very simple yet difficult interview question, that is, tell us about different types of software testing. In this video, we are going to cover most popular 40 testing methods. If you are able to recall at least 10 to 15 during the interview, that will be great. Friends, please turn on the captions of this video for better understanding and don't forget to give thumbs up in the form of like. And if you are new to our channel, please subscribe for more interview questions. Let's begin. Volume testing is a type of non-functional testing performed by the performance testing team. The software or the application undergoes a huge amount of data and volume testing. In this, we check the system behavior and response time of the application when the system came across such a high volume of data. This high volume of data may impact the system performance and speed of the processing time. This testing, which involves identifying weakness in the software, hardware, and the network, is known as vulnerability testing. Malicious program, the hacker can take control of the system if it is vulnerable to such kind of attacks, viruses. So it is necessary to check if those systems undergo vulnerability testing before production. It may identify critical defects, flaws in the security. Under usability testing, user friendliness check is done. The application flow is tested to know if a new user can understand the application easily or not. Proper help documented if a user gets stuck at any point. Basically, system navigation is checked in this testing. White box testing is based on the knowledge about the internal logic of an application's code. It is also known as glass box testing. Internal softwares and code working should be known for performing this type of testing. Under these, tests are based on the coverage of code statement, branches, paths, condition. Now, in unit testing, testing of an individual software component or module is termed as unit testing. It is typically done by the programmer and not by the tester, as it requires detailed knowledge of the internal program design and code. It may also require developing test drives, modules, or test harness. Stress testing. This testing is done when a system is stressed beyond its specification in order to check how and when it fails. This is performed under heavy load, like putting large number of beyond storage capacity, complex database queries, continuous input to the system or database load. Under system testing technique, the entire system is tested as per the requirement. It is a black box type testing, that is based on overall requirement specifications and cover all the combined part of a system. Static testing is a type of testing which is executed without any code. The execution is performed on the documentation during the testing phase. It involves reviews, walkthroughs, and inspection of the deliverables of the project. Static testing does not execute the code instead of the code syntax. Naming conventions are checked. Static testing is also applicable for the test cases, test plan, design document. It is necessary to perform static testing by the testing team, as the defects identified during this type of testing are cost effective from the project perspective. Now, whenever a new build is provided by the development team, then the software testing team validates the build and ensure that no major issue exists. The testing team ensured that the build is stable and a detailed level of testing is carried out further. The smoke testing checks that no showstopper defect exists in the build, which will prevent the testing team to test the application in detail. If testers find that the major critical functionality is broken down at the initial stage itself, then the testing team can reject the build and inform accordingly to the development team. Smoke testing is carried out to a detailed level of any functional or regression testing. It is a type of testing performed by a special team of testers. A system can be penetrated by any hacking way. Security testing is done to check how the software or the application or website is secure from internal or external threats. This testing includes how many software is secure from the malicious program, viruses, and how secure and strong the authorization and authentication process are. It also checks how software behaves for any hackers' attack and malicious programs, and how software is maintained for the data security after such a hacker attack. Testers having the mindset of attitude to break and using negative testing, they validate that if a system or applications break. A negative testing technique is performed using incorrect data, invalid data, or input. It validates that if the system throws an error of invalid input and behaves as expected. Now, sanity testing is done to determine if a new software version is performing well enough to accept it for a major testing effort or not. If an application is crashing for the initial use, then the system is not stable enough for further testing. Therefore, a build or application is assigned to fix it. In risk-based testing, the functionalities or requirements are tested based on their priority. Now, this risk-based testing includes testing of highly critical functionality which has the highest impact on business and in which the probability of failure is very high. The priority decision is based on the business need. So once priority is set for all the functionalities, then high priority functionalities or test cases are executed first, followed by medium and then low priority functionalities. Now, it is a type of testing which validate how well the application or system recovers from crashes or disaster. Now, recovery testing determine if the system is able to continue the operation after a disaster. Assume that application is receiving data through the network cable, or suddenly that network cable has been unplugged. Sometime later, plug the network cable, then the system should start receiving data from where it lost the connection due to network cable unplugged. Now, performance testing. This term is often used interchangeably with stress and load testing. Performance testing is done to check whether the system meets the performance requirements. During performance and load tools are used to do the testing. It is a type of testing for which every organization having a separate team is usually called a non-functional test team or a performance team. Non-functional testing involves testing of non-functional requirement. It should not take much time to load any page or system and should sustain during peak load. Now, mutation testing is a type of white box testing in which the source code of one of the program is changed and verifies whether the existing test cases can identify these defects in the system. Now, monkey testing is carried out by a tester assuming that if the monkey uses the application, then how random input values will be entered by the monkey without any knowledge or understanding of the application. Therefore, the name monkey testing. The testing of all integrated modules to verify the combined functionality after integration is termed as integration testing. Modules are typically code modules, individual applications, client and server applications on network. This type of testing is especially relevant to client server and distributed systems. Now, incremental integration testing is a bottom-up approach for testing, that is, continuous testing of an application when new functionality is added. Application functionality and modules should be independent enough to test separately. This is done by programmer or by tester. The objective of happy path testing is to test an application successfully on a positive flow. It does not look for a negative or error conditions. The focus is only on a valid and positive inputs through which applications generate the expected output. Now, gorilla testing is a testing type performed by a tester and sometimes by the developer as well. In gorilla testing, one module or the functionality in the module is tested thoroughly and heavily. The objective of this testing is to check the robustness of the application. The objective of this GUI testing is to validate the GUI as per the business requirement. The expected GUI of the application is mentioned in the detailed design document and graphical user interface mockup screens. Exploratory testing is informal testing performed by the testing team. The objective of this testing is to explore the application and looking for defects that exist in the application. It is a testing technique and a type of black box testing. During this equivalence partitioning, a set of the group is selected and a few values or numbers are picked up for the testing. It is understood that all values from that group generate the same output. The aim of this testing is to remove redundant test cases within a specific group which generate the same output, but not any defect. Suppose the application accepts values between minus 10 to plus 10. So using equivalence partitioning, the value picked up for the testing are 0, one positive value, one negative value. So the equivalence partitioning of this testing is minus 10 to minus 1, 0, and 1 to 10. Similar to system testing, end-to-end testing involves testing of a complete application environment in a situation that mimics real-world use, such as interacting with a database, using network communication, or interacting with other hardware applications or systems if appropriate. It is a testing type in which it validates how software behaves and runs in a different environment, web servers, hardware, and network environment. Compatibility testing ensures that software can run on a different configuration, different database, different browsers, and their versions. Compatibility testing is performed by the testing team. This type of testing checks the behavior of the application at boundary level. The boundary value testing is performed for checking if defects exist at boundary values. Boundary value testing is used for testing a different range of numbers. There is an upper and lower boundary for each range, and testing is performed on these boundary values. Now, it is a type of testing which validates whether the newly developed software or updated software work well with the older version of the environment or not. Backward compatibility testing checks whether the new version of the software works properly with the file format created by the older version of the software. It also works well with the data tables, data files, data structures created by the older version of that software. If any of the software is updated, then it should work well on the top of the previous version of that software. It is a subtype of compatibility testing, and it is performed by the testing team. Browser compatibility testing is performed for web applications, and it ensures that the software can run with the combination of different browsers and operating system. This type of testing also validates whether web applications runs on all versions of all the browsers or not. Whenever an input or data is entered on front-end application, it is stored in the database, and the testing of such database is known as database testing or back-end testing. There are different databases like SQL Server, MySQL, and Oracle, etc. The database testing involves testing of table, structure, schema, stored procedure, data structure, and so on. Beta testing is a formal type of software testing which is carried out by the customer. It is performed in the real environment before releasing the product to the market for the actual end user. Now, the aim of accessibility testing is to determine whether the software or application is accessible for disabled people or not. Here, disability means deaf, colorblind, mentally disabled, blind, old age, and other disabled groups. Various checks are performed such as font size for visually disabled, color and contrast for color blindness, etc. In black box testing, internal system design is not considered in this type of testing. Tests are based on the requirements and functionality. The name itself suggests that this testing is performed on an ad hoc basis, that is, with no reference to the test cases and also without any plan or documentation in place for such type of testing. An acceptance test is performed by the client and verifies whether the end-to-end, the flow of the system is as per the business requirement or not. If it is as per the needs of the end user, client accepts the software only when all the features and functionalities work as expected. It is the last phase of the testing, after which the software goes into the production. That's the reason it is also called user acceptance testing, UAT. Now, it is the most common type of testing used in the software industry, the alpha testing. The objective of this testing is to identify all possible issues or defects before release it into the market or to the user. Example testing, it means real-time testing. Example testing includes the real-time scenarios. It also involves the scenarios based on the experience of the tester. Now, installation and uninstallation testing is done on full, partial, or upgrade, install, uninstall processes on different operating system under different hardware or software environment. Load testing. It is a type of non-functional testing, and the objective of load testing is to check how much load or maximum workload a system can handle without any performance degradation. Load testing helps to find the maximum capacity of the system under specific load and any issues that cause software performance degradation. Load testing is performed using tools like JMeter, LoadRunner, WebLoad, SelfPerformer, and so many. Hey, thanks everyone. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more similar videos. Bye. Have a nice day.